A tearful apology indeed, Jen. You know, the Attorney General's office calling this the most disturbing case of theft they've seen, citing the high level of trust that the Monsignor enjoyed from colleagues and parishioners who believed that their contributions were going to charitable causes, not high-end restaurants and flowers for a male friend.
The admitted thief entered court in a suit, clutching a Bible. Less than an hour later, Monsignor Ed Arsenault led away in handcuffs to begin serving 4 years in prison.
This is probably one of the more difficult and disturbing cases we've seen in the theft arena at the Attorney General's office.
The former Manchester Diocese official pled guilty to stealing $185,000 from Catholic Medical Center, the estate of a dead priest, and the Diocese of Manchester.
I'm truly and sincerely sorry for what I did. And I apologize to the many people who have been harmed by my actions.
The apology, too little too late for this former parishioner.
To tell you the truth, the best part of the day was to see those handcuffs go on his wrists.
Arsenault admitted he spent the money on trips to San Francisco and New York, pricey restaurants, flowers for his friend Luke Perkin, a composer in his 40s who lives in Florida, extended stay hotels for Perkin, prescriptions, and cell phones. Arsenault billed CMC triple the consulting work that he actually performed. That part of the investigation is ongoing.
We are looking at that contract and looking at the amount that he stole to determine if anybody else has any liability for that theft. What was the extent of knowledge of Catholic Medical Center?
Supporters of Arsenault sent letters to the court. Defense attorney Kathy Green cited her client's staunch commitment to the church.
During the tumultuous period that the church child sex abuse scandal was going on, Mr. Arsenault was the person who held the diocese together.
That restitution is already underway. Arsenault handed over two checks adding up to $25,000 today in court. He is required to maintain a life insurance policy and turn over any proceeds from any writings he does while he's in prison. Also, his retirement fund has been garnished. Live in the newsroom, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.